During the 3rd millennium BC, two new archaeological pottery styles expanded across Europe and replaced many of the more localized styles that had preceded them. The expansion of the corded ware complex in northern, central and northeastern Europe was associated with peoples who derived most of their ancestry from populations related to the early Bronze Age Yamnaya pastoralist from the Eurasian steppe. In Western Europe, there was the equally expansive Bell Beaker complex, defined by assemblages of grave goods that included stylized bell-shaped pots, copper daggers, arrowheads, stone wrist guards and V-perforated buttons. The forces that propelled its expansions are a matter of long-standing debate. There is support for both cultural diffusion and migration having a role in this process. In the paper, the Bell Beaker phenomenon and the genomic transformation of the Northwest Europe in Nature, they present genome-wide data from 400 Neolithic, Copper Age and Bronze Age Europeans, including 226 individuals associated with the Beaker complex artifacts. From a principal component analysis, projecting the ancient samples onto the genetic variation in a set of West European present-day populations, it becomes evident that individuals associated with the Beaker complex were notably heterogeneous within the European clan along an axis of variation defined by early Bronze Age Yamnaya individuals from the steppe at one extreme and Middle Neolithic and Copper Age Europeans at the other extreme. This suggests that the genetic differentiation among Beaker complex associated and individuals may be related to variable amounts of steppe-related ancestry. They find that in areas outside of Iberia, with the exception of Sicily, a large majority of the Beaker complex associated individuals that were sampled derive a considerable proportion of their ancestry from steppe populations. For example, in Britain, there is nearly a complete turnover of ancestry. By contrast, in Iberia, such ancestry is present only in 8 of the 32 individuals analyzed. Also, Beaker complex associated individuals from the Iberian Peninsula carried a higher proportion of Y haplogroups known to be common across Europe during the earlier Neolithic period. They examined whether populations predating the emergence of the Beaker complex shared more alleles with Iberia or Central European line aardvark ceramic early Neolithic populations. They find that Iberian Middle Neolithic and Copper Age populations, but not Central and Northern European populations, had genetic affinities with Iberian early Neolithic farmers. These regional patterns could partially be explained by the differential genetic affinities to the pre-Neolithic hunter-gatherer individuals from different regions. Neolithic individuals from southern France and Britain are also significantly closer to Iberian early Neolithic farmers than they are to Central European early Neolithic farmers. Their results suggest that a proportion of the ancestry of the Neolithic populations of Britain was derived from migrants who spread along the Atlantic coast. Megalithic tombs document substantial interaction along the Atlantic facade of Europe, and the results are consistent with such interactions reflecting south to north movement of people as well. That is it for today. Thank you for listening. Till next time, I wish you all the best.